poet that aroma can do. Brought a date for me and you.
The best part of waking up is in your cup.
This holiday season, every time you purchase a 12-ounce Starbucks coffee, a portion of the proceeds will be given to the Penny Foundation, the world's premier charity dedicated to helping down-on-their-luck content creators pay their daily bills.
I need that money. I really do. I need that money to pay my bills, the electric bill, the internet bill.
So stop by your local Starbucks today and help send some Penny their way.
Oh boy, it's been a long journey, but it's been worth every minute of it. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to, Merry Christmas / Goutmas / Snoutmas here at GTG Network and Productions. It's been a long road. Now, to be honest, I hope that most of you aren't actually watching this at least early Christmas Day. Hopefully, you guys are spending time with your friends, loved ones. You can watch it later on that evening and whatnot after you got some eggnog in you, some really good bourbon or whiskey or scotch or something, and you just kind of want to laugh or something before you end up nightcapping it, if you will. Or you're saving this for a work day or whatever the case may be, or just a day where you can just sit around and chill. This is kind of what this is for and whatnot. So even if you guys don't get to see this on Christmas Day, which is fine, I would prefer you guys don't. Season's greetings and happy holidays. Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a long road. There's been some bumps in the road, obviously, some missteps and some mess-ups, which it wouldn't be a GTG project if there wasn't. But thank you guys for giving me the opportunity, giving me the chance to do so. This is my first project, big project, on this channel, and it'll be the second year in a row I've done it on the main channel. And it was fun. It's... If anything else, being on this channel, which is smaller, it's different. You know what I'm saying? Because like you're not going through the motions per se. It's just, I guess maybe, just maybe, you don't have so much that you feel that's on your shoulders, I suppose. You know what I'm saying? On a smaller channel, and that and also the excitement of watching the channel grow. You know what I'm saying? That something that you're doing is starting to build up and catch a little bit of traction or whatever the case may be. I find that to be something rather exciting about having a small channel. Also, with that being said, I have another announcement, I guess. I'm not sure when I'm going to do it yet, but I will do it soon. Because that's going to be for 2020. And it's going to be focused on... we'll talk about that when it comes up. Ladies and gentlemen, yet again, season's greetings, happy holidays. Merry Christmas. / Snoutmas, if you will. And this is the final broadcast as it pertains to our 12 days of Snoutmas. Now, normally I would actually tell you what the video is before we go into it. This time we're not going to. You're going to actually get to unwrap it yourself, and then I'll cut in about a minute in or so and actually give you guys the title. The link to the video will be down in the description. If that link still exists, it should. It should. If not, I'm sure there'll be an alternate somewhere. I'll try to get that and I'll put it down in the description for you so you can watch it without my annoying voice. Thank you guys very much for everything that you've given, not just myself, but everybody here at GTG Network and Productions, the Snort Report, Snort Bucks Coffee, Hard Snorts, which is our next adventure. And then we got like a Tim Snorton type thing in the works for our friends up north in Canada, which I hope to roll out in 2020. It's thank you guys for everything. Like, you know what I'm saying? There's no amount of money that you can put in or that you can put down for what people have given me and I would have never expected it because I didn't go in for that. I just wanted to, I had something to say. I only had an opinion. That's all it was. And, you know, I took, you take the hits, win, lose, or draw. But thank you so very much. It's amazing to know that Phil, it's amazing to me that a lot of you who used to follow Phil in some way, shape, or form, how he was able to cast you guys to the side so quickly in some cases for something that wasn't even sustainable. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if nothing else, Phil didn't need as much money as he made. He didn't need the BMW. He didn't need the pariah type attitude and atmosphere around him. What he needed is he needed just good people around him. And he had that, but he cast that all aside for money, believing that if he had money, that would draw people in. It's amazing how misguided he was, which leads to how misguided he is now. Either which way, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for just being on this ride with us. It's been great. And let's go ahead and get into the final gift of the holiday season, if you will. I might try to do a Christmas video too, but if not, then it'll be just this. So, yet again, season's greetings and happy holidays, everybody. Here we go.
DSP, Dark Side Phil, a man with a self-described YouTube legacy. And looking at his metrics, you get an idea of where that notion arises, what germinated that concept in his little mind. Nearly 500 million video views, 50 fucking thousand uploads. I know gang stalking channels that film the sidewalk every day that don't come anywhere near that amount of uploads. But that is the dedication that...
Ladies and gentlemen, that's just... That's 48,000 uploads on just one channel, though.
Phil has to his craft of playing video games on the internet. And that passion project turned profession drew in quite an audience for Phil. But internet celebrity being what it is, a fickle thing, with audiences eventually dissipating as the years go on. Phil's numbers have waned quite a bit. And yet still, he retains a certain popularity or interest in what he does in the videos that he produces, but just in an unintended way. If you were to go to YouTube right now and enter, "This is how you don't play."
This is how you don't play, indeed. Actually, ladies and gentlemen, I just got a small message that we're actually going to mirror this video on this channel. So yet again, we'll leave you a link, but this video will be mirrored as well. Probably right after this video goes out. So you guys have that too. I need to start archiving more DSP-related videos, certain more obscure ones. I need to start mirroring them. So that's something we're also going to do on this channel. It'll be a nice little depository, if you will. Speaking of which, I should pass that message along to the Museum of Unnatural, of the Galtopia Museum of Unnatural Art. I should let him know that too, because that's a good idea. I'm going to reach out to our friend Loco Slam, who's the curator of that museum, and follow him on Twitter. It's great. It's a to follow him on Twitter and whatnot, and I'm going to let him know that. All right, but we're definitely going to mirror this original video over here as well. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys yet again very much for participating with us with the 12 Days of Galtmas. And to cap that off, right, hopefully you guys have your drink of choice ready, whether some eggnog with some scotch or brandy or whiskey in it, or just some hot chocolate or whatnot, or some coffee or some tea from our Snortbucks shop, whatever the case may be. We are here with the King of Catfish. Well, with Mr. Medicare. King of Catfish. Oh boy, ladies and gentlemen. Oh boy. Here we go. Yet again, season's greetings and happy holidays, guys. Here we go.
The majority of search results you're going to get are all going to be DSP related. And that's because Phil, ironically enough, is shit at video games. You would figure somebody that dedicates their life to something would actually be good at it, but you would be wrong. And there is quite a sizable audience dedicated to watching Phil fuck up his playthroughs of any title you could imagine. Game after game after game after game, they come out to watch him fail once again. Simply
here, I'm actually going to increase the size of the video, so this way some of this comes out a bit more, you get more visibility out of it. I'll expand it a little bit more than I normally would. It's a special day, ladies and gentlemen, a special day.
Pairing a video that Phil himself puts out to a This Is How You Don't Play, released on the very same day, makes it crystal clear exactly...
Oh, Outsider! Good shit, the Outsider's there. Good shit. Happy holidays to all of our fellow detractors out there as well.
What the audience is tuning in for. The discrepancy in the numbers is astronomical. And it's this reputation that's begun to cling to him over the last 4 or 5 years. But that's not the only thing he's known for. Mr. Bunnell is a man of many talents. Not many people can say they've masturbated in front of children on Twitch TV. I should put allegedly in there in quotation marks because we can't prove that's happening. There's no shot below the waist as he's furiously moving his arms and throwing his head back in exuberation in the moment, because apparently he forgot that his webcam was on before he...
That's the fastest I think I've ever seen Phil move. Like, just how you see his arm going through a seizure right there. That's probably the fastest I've ever seen him move. And there is the infamous bald spot on his beard. So good! Now, let's talk a little bit about this situation. A little bit. There is a theory going around that still exists to this day, and for good reason, to be honest, that Phil staged this. And most of you are like, well, why the hell would Phil do that? Well, notoriety, obviously. It's the one thing that stuck with him that he'll never be able to wash off. He could never get unstuck from this. But also, there was a female Hearthstone player who it was planned. I think it's well known now that she planned it. Who had accidentally masturbated and kept her stream on to give everybody an amazing show. You can find it. Look it up. And that's all I'm going to tell you. If you really want to see it, you can look it up. It still exists. And that particular situation, I believe, was right around this time. And Phil was struggling. He needed people. He needed something. You know what I'm saying? And if you look at his analytics around that time, he got what he was looking for. He got the buzz that he was looking for. It didn't last long. Just like he didn't. Poor Leanna. Poor Catherine, too. It didn't last very long, but it gave him his momentary moment, if you will. It gave him his infusion, if you will, of popularity for a briefest of moments. Sure, Phil knows all about that. So it wouldn't be out of the realm to believe that, you know, it might have not. It's possible that it could have been staged. We'll never know. But, and everybody reported on this, like all over. Like, Phil will never make that go away. Ever. Ever. It's ingrained, excuse me, not just into his mythos, into his legacy, but into online gaming itself. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm surprised that Tosh, is it Tosh.0, didn't actually try to do a segment on this. And the reason why I bring that up is because when you think about the low-tier god versus Vince Scant situation, they wanted to actually have a skit to actually kind of relive that moment, right? Because that is a part of not only internet history, video game history, FGC history. It'd be funny if someone did a small skit about this shit too. That'd been hilarious. Hilarious. Nick Cannon's hilarious. No, he's not. Anyway, but that never happened. It doesn't need to. You know what I'm saying? Some content creator will make one, and it'll work out either which way. Anyway, let's continue.
He went live on a stream in front of a giant audience. That's a little bit of an oops. That's a tiny bit of a fuck-up. And it's because of weird happenstances like this, of jacking off on a camera unaware that people are watching you, or being terrible at a video game, or even having a bit of an attitude, that Phil has attracted what he likes to call detractors. Now, detractors are individuals who have a nearly A-log-like obsession with Phil's life, some going as far as building water wells in Africa just to say they're better than some fat YouTuber that plays video games all day. And no, I'm really not making that up. And it's not just those dirty detractors that give Phil shit, that catalog his videos and create compilations, or mock his inability to do things properly, or the failures that he seemingly exhibits on a daily basis. His fans give him enough trouble as well. Certain individuals that follow him cause more trouble than they may be worth. But this video isn't really about Phil Burnell. It's not about DSP. If you want to really get a good idea of the crazy backstory related to him, to his online shenanigans, and the groups of people that have dedicated their life to cataloging or fucking with him, I would highly recommend Down the Rabbit Hole, which covers it in a spectacular fashion. I'll put a link in the description. You can go watch it for backstory on exactly who this guy is and the things that he gets into. So no, this...
Yeah, that is actually a great video. That is actually a very great video. Maybe that'll show up in the routine next year, or the rotation. I'll link that video down in the description too, the Down the Rabbit Hole. You guys should definitely watch that. It's a great video. So I'll definitely put that in there.
Video won't be focusing on Phil. Instead, it's going to focus on events surrounding him. Now, one last thing you really need to know as we get into this is that after winning Boyfriend of the Year awards for 2016 and 2017, Phil and his girlfriend, Panda Lee Gaming, broke up. I'm not sure why.
Back to back.
What could possibly have driven a wedge between these two star-crossed lovers?
Leanna's awake. She's not been feeling too well. I want to make sure she's awake because she has to start making dinner. Give me a second. I'll be right back.
The thing is, I know if this ever happens again, I'm going to tell him you are not allowed to bring her to the hospital. No. No, you get no permission to fucking do it.
Who does that? Who says to their fucking girlfriend, their fiance, their wife, you can't go to the hospital? The next time you get into a position where you need to go to the emergency room, you walk it the fuck off. Toughen up, Buttercup. Well, at least now we know where Phil got his nickname King of Hate, because Leanna most definitely hates his ass for not letting her go to urgent care when she desperately needs it. So the end of 2017 was a rough patch for Phil, what with his financial difficulties that he repeatedly talked about on stream, saying that he had hardships coming up and that he was scared. And now with his girlfriend leaving him, how could things possibly get any worse for DSP?
Oh boy. Yummy, yum, yum. Before we actually get into that, as of recent, and I don't advise anybody to do this, for obvious reasons, let her, she's free. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, we'll crack our jokes and everything like that, but in actuality, she's free. So she should be, she's off the table, if you will, from any direct contact with whatever's going on in the detractor community or in the Phil spectrum at them as of right now. But someone reached out to Panda on or Leanna on Instagram and was like, and basically they were like, hey, you know, we're glad you're doing well, so on and so forth. Phil though still seems to have a level of disdain for you and so on and so forth, and it doesn't look like he's really gotten over your breakup. I'm paraphrasing, but you know, and they were like, you know, any thoughts on this? And this kind of shows some of her growth since she's left Phil, where she was like, I hold no ill will towards Phil or anybody else that I've met, and I wish them the best. It was short, it was sweet, and it was to the point. Which, in my view, in a lot of people's view actually, it shows that she's truly moved on. At the same time, there's no need to sit there and try to prod her, or try to get a response out of her. Just let her go. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know what I mean? Just let her, she has her own life now, she's going through her own stuff. Bringing Phil up to her on Instagram or on whatever platform is just not the way to go. Just my opinion, of course, but it is what it is. But that shows you where she thinks of Phil, detractors, his own people, and his own fan base. She's moved on from all that. She doesn't dwell on it. She doesn't need to dwell on it. Good for her. Now, let's get into Miss Kimberly Brink, shall we?
I'm a little pissed off right now. If it doesn't change by this weekend, I'm going to release...
Get it? Let's get into Kimberly, because she was allegedly a prostitute. Not even a prostitute, a high-end escort. Okay, if I have to explain the joke, it's not very good. Sorry. Just retcon all that. Womp womp.
It's a screenshot I took from my DM. I don't like to be treated like this, just saying. By the way, by now I also know where to send it to. They will have a damn field day with this if they ever get their hands on it. I say just this. Pay me, motherfucker.
That nigga gonna pay what he owe.
Or you're going to be so sorry you wish I had cut your tiny fucking cock off instead. Not even the backlash you'll be getting from my husband who oversees my business. Well, it would appear that Kimberly Brink has an issue with DSP. It looks like she's owed some motherfucking money. But what's it in relation to? Well, true to her word, Kimberly did know where to release that information to. Over on the forum, Kiwi Farms, a mysterious woman shows up to elaborate on what's going on. It turns out that Kimberly Brink was a high-end European escort. DSP had contracted her on more than one occasion to come over and give him the real girlfriend experience for a weekend. Apparently, the loneliness after Leanna had left him had driven him to hiring people from overseas. She goes on to explain they had a contract between them, and that there was a non-disclosure agreement in play, but that if he didn't pay the money he owed her by a certain date, roughly 30 days from the point of her posting that, she would be free to give out every intimate detail of their relationship. And apparently the money that she was owed was roughly around $3,000. I guess European whores have a pussy payment program. If you want to get laid, you put it on layaway. And that's exactly what she's alleging that DSP had done. And even with that supposed NDA in play, she was still willing to give out some rather embarrassing details within the first post that she put up on Kiwi Farms. Now,
that shit was crazy. So, a little bit of backstory on my end. So, this was like my first, big story that I was following. Now, from the beginning, right? And you can go back into my old videos and whatnot. I throw out there the speculation, because we all did, everybody that was here at GTG Network and Productions at the time, that it might not be true. So, this is all alleged. But Jesus Christ, I ain't gonna front. I followed this story pretty heavily over that span of the month and a half, whatever it was. That shit was amazing. You know what I mean? The links that they went through, that Kimberly went through, we're gonna go along with the story, to convince people. She showed up under Snor Brunel videos, under my video, under a bunch of detractor videos. She reached out to us on Twitter. It was some amazing shit. It was absolutely amazing. And then, you know, jumping on Kiwi Farms, following Twitter, trying to grab screenshots and everything. It was exciting. It was absolutely exciting. Even though it might not have been true, it's a story. And it's a story that needed to be told. That shit was absolutely ridiculous. It was ridiculous. And that's one of the amazing things about Phil Brunel, is that he has the best, worst fucking luck ever. He really does. If I was condemned to hell, right? And an angel said, hey, you're going to be reborn as Phil Brunel. And I'll pull you from this right now. And you'll never, ever have to go back, no matter what you do. I would be like, no. And the reason why I would be no is because the stipulation would be you have to relive his worst life experiences. Hell no. Hell no. It's not worth it. It's amazing in a lot of ways that Phil Brunel was able to make it to where he did and to accomplish, in air quotes, what he was able to accomplish. But at what cost? You know what I'm saying? At what cost? You know, Medicare speaks of clown world a lot, right? And it's a fitting term. Well, Phil is the embodiment of clown world. He represents the best, the worst, the most ignorant, the most ill-informed aspects of human nature. And he just keeps on doing it. He keeps on figuring out a way to get himself into these situations. And even if he has if he's not involved at all in that actual situation, somehow he gets pulled in and it forces him to reveal things that he wasn't planning on revealing. And that's what makes these situations just extraordinary. Absolutely extraordinary. But let's continue with the storyline.
He spilled the beans and sausage here regarding dipshit Phil's tiny instrument. Yes, he is a man. He has a dick, but my oh my, I should have brought a magnifying glass, because when fully erect, if you can even call it erect, it was hardly 4 inches long and not very pleasurable, but I guess that was what he was born with, so I can't blame him for that. He is, however, a quick squirter, because sex didn't last long. A couple minutes at most, so not very pleasurable for me. No idea how Leanna lasted that long with him, but I'm sure she had more than enough toys to satisfy her while he was busy gaming, working. Reading Kimberly's early posts, you quickly pick up on the fact that they are particularly annoyed they're owed money and really want to get back at Phil for not paying what he owes. As I said before, guys, believe what you want, it's your right to do so. I don't care who believes me or not, and really don't give a damn. All I'm saying is the thirst for money will grow even bigger for him, because not paying me brings it to a whole other level than having to pay taxes. I'll leave it at that. I've said enough to get things off my chest, because I was, and still am, seriously pissed for the way he handled me since I got back home. And now, till a point, he broke all responding contact. He has, like, a month, since I'm very reasonable when it comes to it. But if the due date is passed, I'm going after him. You have to pay what you owe.
I'm coming for that ass again, until you pay what you owe.
Simple as that. And with that, I leave it. Have a nice day, all. Now, that post went up on December 15th, so she was giving Phil 30 days to pay the $3,000 she said he owed her before she broke the non-disclosure agreement and released the contracts he had signed with her, along with all the intimate sexual details of their liaisons over the past few months. Now, when these tweets and the posts on Kiwi Farms first came out, people were fairly skeptical. How are they going to be able to substantiate that this woman is, in fact, a whore for hire? Well, it turns out Kimberly had a website, Slut Kimberly, the most extreme escort date you will ever find. And the website looked very fleshed out. It had rates and booking information.
And that's another interesting thing about this whole con, is that these people knew what they were doing. They had done their research. You know what I'm saying? So, like, for example, people talk about, wow, why would you guys put all your time into this nobody like Darkside Phil? But the amount of time, effort, and research they put into this con was on some next level shit. Now, granted, you'll find out later why these people aren't, this wasn't their first rodeo. But even still, like, the details, like, the devil's in the details, right? And if you weren't someone who was completely into the DSP sphere, right, and you didn't have a whole lot of experience with it, you might think, oh shit, this might actually be legit. And that's the reason why people like Almighty Tevin and Argent is another person I really enjoy his content. Some of the bigger hitters didn't actually have a comment on any of this stuff yet. They just want to see how it played out. And it made sense. It made sense to do that. But the story was still very, very impressive. Very, very impressive. But let's continue with our timeline.
Pics and videos, a blog, extra information, scheduling, when she was available, links to other websites she was affiliated with. It was a fully fleshed out website. And looking at the rates this crazy bitch was charging, you can see why Phil would have owed her so much money. After all, a 2-week special would be $125,000. And if you
want the same amount that he owes on his condo currently in Connecticut, you know, the one he's about to lose. Womp womp.
Wanted a 1-month special with Slut Kimberly. Well, that's going to cost you $200,000. So it's totally understandable why Phil decided to go the reasonable route of $6,000 for the girlfriend experience. You might want to just baby step your way into that before you jump into the $250,000 fuck fest with Slut Kimberly from Europe. Now, within a few days, within about 48 to 72 hours, Phil began to respond to this. People were bringing it up to him. Stupid people looking for drama are incredibly gullible. They will believe anything they're told that creates a scandal, whether or not there's any factual evidence at all. And sadly, a lot of human beings are stupid. I know firsthand. I have to deal with tons of them daily. Lol.
For several days, they kept saying that my girlfriend was some girl who had tweeted me months and months ago during the summer for like one random conversation, and they basically kept spamming the shit out of her Twitter, saying that she was my girlfriend, to the point where she basically flipped out and said, no, I'm not his girlfriend, you fucking idiots. Ridiculous, right? Now, they're trying to say that apparently my girlfriend is a paid escort. What? It's just insanity. So I just got a troll sub from someone claiming Phil's dating an escort named Kim. Sure I am. You have to be...
Now, let me fill you guys in a little bit. So around this time, when with this whole girlfriend thing, right? Which is why the escort saga ended up playing well into the detractor hands, because it forced Phil to divulge, you know, not just the girlfriend, but end up the long-term effects was him actually revealing her against his better judgment. He had no choice to put it out because publicly he was labeled for paying for entertainment. He had to pay for the warm embrace of a woman. So now he had to put it out there. He had to put Catherine or Kat out there for the masses to dispel everything. So that worked towards the detractors, to the detractors' favor, obviously. But it also, in a very interesting sort of way, was also it was like the hunt for Red Pigtober, I should say, which reminds me of a piece of fan art that Aladdin made on Twitter. Shouts out to Aladdin. Which was a semblance of that, because there was like three or four girls that had reached, or women I should say, who reached out to Phil, at least I hope they were women, at that time, who was speaking to him. There was a Josephine, there was a Sarah, and there was someone else. I can't think of what the other young lady's name was, who were all looked at as potential love interest or girlfriends, and people trying to find out who this girlfriend thing was. It was, you got to understand, this whole escort saga thing was just one small part that led into a much bigger thing. Blood for the Blood Gods, Brightside Vikings, war against Kiwi Farms. There was a bunch of stuff that was going on around this. You know what I mean? Which was just amazing. And I know a lot of people are waiting for that next big saga. We're not going to get anything like this again, I don't think. I think it was kind of just a perfect storm type situation, but I'll talk about that further later on. But it forced Phil's hand on the girlfriend he had, Kat or Catherine, and then it made people go back and look at some of these other potential women who have reached out to Phil at one time or another and see what their deal was. The detractors, the trolls, the haters, the critics, they dissected his life. You know what I mean? In such a way that Phil hasn't recovered to this day. To be honest, whenever he's hiding something or, oh, I'm lying to you guys for my, you know, for the safety of my family and shit, shit on all that. It always comes out. It always comes out, which goes back to the GTG Network and Productions motto. You give him enough rope, he'll hang himself. Just give him time. He'll screw himself over. It's in his nature.
I'm complete brain dead idiot. To even consider paying for an escort to begin with. And then to say, oh, yes, a fan of Phil's who followed him, and now he's going to pay her to come. You're fucking so stupid.
So it appeared that the two were at an impasse. Slut Kimberly was saying that DSP owed her money. DSP was saying, I have no idea who the fuck this is, and you have to be an idiot to believe them. Now, even putting aside that the Twitter account in question was many years old, and that it linked to her own personal escort website that you could actually use to book her services, people pointed to other things they thought substantiated Kimberly's story, different pieces of evidence, or things they had noticed over the last couple of months. The mysterious new girlfriend that DSP claimed he had. He posted pictures of her, but only from behind. He was afraid...
Now, here's another thing, too. I'm actually glad you brought this up. And like I said, we'll go over this at a later time and date. I'm really skeptical that this is Catherine. Like, it just, the shape of her is different. Obviously Catherine was dyeing her hair red, because her hair is just not this, it's not, I guess that would be what, more like a scarlet? Is that what it would be, like a scarlet red, or maybe even a blood red? I don't know, I'm gonna say scarlet red. But anyway, I don't know. I'm skeptical that this was Catherine. It just, the body type don't look right. When you see, you've seen Catherine before, and then you look at this here, and it's like, I'm having a hard time believing it. And then, look at these creepy-ass fucking stalker-like pictures, which is even more ironic because when we see pictures of Catherine now, like when she's in her gaming room, for example, playing on her PC or on her console, we get these same type of angles. Something to think about. Really weird.
People were going to find out what her identity was, and they were going to target her to harass her. Well, the pictures he posted, Kimberly posted similar pictures saying that those were actually her, and she posted them on her own private account. Even more than that, if you look at her timeline and DSP's timeline, they talk about the same thing, but spaced out by hours. Kimberly's talking about how traveling is difficult on the 15th, very early in the morning. And then later on in the afternoon, DSP's talking about his girlfriend and how she just went through this arduous journey to come visit him and then go back home. And Kimberly...
Very weird. A very weird situation. And circumstance. I thought that too. A lot of people did. It was really hard to kind of match all that up.
Why
would Phil go out of his way to corroborate her story, so to speak?
Bent on making them believe what she said. She was out for blood. She was talking about reporting him to both Twitch and Patreon for hiring whores with their... I don't know if that's in the terms of service somewhere. I don't remember Jack Conte saying you couldn't pay for pussy on his platform. Maybe that's buried in, like, subsection 8, and I'm unaware of it. But she was spreading the word around everywhere she could to smear him for not giving her that $3,000. People were messaging him on social media, constantly asking him about the escort services he hired. He had to repeatedly address it time and time and time again on his live stream.
So they fabricate this story that I hired an escort to come visit me during my Christmas break. I paid her thousands of dollars or owe her thousands of dollars, apparently. I don't even know what the full story is because I'm not really following it. I don't deal with this stupid shit. But you may have noticed the past few days, there's idiots coming in here. It's all the fucking same gullible morons who believe everything because they're such morons. They've been coming in here saying, oh, you owe money to your escort. What about your escort? These people are fucking idiots. They actually believe this. That's the sad part, that they're actually so gullible. They actually believe this is fact. My God, you people are stupid if you believe that shit. I shake my head at how stupid it is that these dumb, gullible kids, they will literally fabricate anything to create drama just so there's drama. Because right now, let's face it, what drama is there? I mean, yeah, financially I'm in a bind, but people have been very supportive. People are coming out on streams and being very positive, right? There's not a lot of negativity around me right now, which is good. In fact, it's the holiday season, so things have been going really well. So let's fabricate something, because there's really not much negative to say about Phil these days. So let's just make shit up. Oh, he hired an escort to come during Christmas. It's like, what?
And even
he hired an escort to come during Christmas. Interesting wording. But not just that, though. Phil benefited from this, too, a little bit. You know what I mean? Because it did bring a lot of viewership in, because people wanted to hear what he had to say about it. On top of that, some of his supporters did rally around him, and, they contributed a little bit more, given the circumstances. A lot of them actually went out there to try to fact check a lot of this situation to see if they could break it down, which kind of leads to why Brightside Viking ended up going to Kiwi Farms, one of the reasons of Brightside Viking going to Kiwi Farms. But then again, he did lose some people over this too. So there's that thing. If you guys remember the Brownie Saga, there's that mod that he ended up losing over that.
Though DSP consistently denied it time and time again, Kimberly began to post that he was back on a payment program with her and that she was getting the $3,000 that she was owed. And so her threat of releasing more information by the 15th of January seemed to completely come and go. The thread got hundreds of replies. People constantly talked about it on social media. They kept pestering DSP about it. But at the end of the day, it looked like the issue was going to be laid to rest. Kimberly was claiming she was getting her money. Either way, it looks like it was over. Until Kimberly once again jumped back in to restart it, after she claimed that she got paid by him. As to why I started posting about DSP again, well, I was done with him because he finally paid 2 weeks ago. But guess what? He started trash-talking about me, so he can of course expect the same in return. Hey DSP, just a reminder, you started this. The first time I had to start trouble because you refused to pay me for my services. Now 2 weeks ago, you finally paid, so I went quiet about it and let it go. But last night, you decided to slander me, so what did you expect, huh? And from this point forward, Kimberly goes into detail about the financial arrangement they had between them, publicly talking about it, no longer on the Mystery Woman account, doing it out in the open. She takes it a step further by going into intimate detail about their bedroom behavior. Hey, DSP, remember when you sent me this pic last September when you asked me if it was a good one? I sure made good use of it on your ass when I was with you, didn't I? Okay, listen, maybe it's the fucking reflective nature of the tinfoil behind it, but it's hard to tell off the black dildo. Is that a horse cock? The shape of it doesn't seem quite natural. Is she saying that she fucked DSP with a strap-on horse cock? Because that's kind of the direction it seems like Kimberly is going with this. I think this girl
now. Oh, that's silly shit. Oh my god. Now, the reason why that's funny, at least to me anyway, is Phil's very strange obsession with having things that, with things being inserted up his ass or other people's asses. So the fact that Black Horse's dildo ended up showing up in this amazing odyssey is, I found that to be extremely hilarious. For as much shit he talks about everybody being a pain in his ass or shoving stuff up other people's ass and shit like that, you have a fake escort. You have an escort, I should say. She hasn't been broken down as being fake yet. Coming around saying that you paid her to insert a black horse dildo up your ass. It was so good! It was so good! Like, the amount of research they put into this was pretty fucking wild. It's absolutely wild.
Actually be crazy enough to believe her own bullshit. Some people can actually convince themselves that they were places if they talk about it enough. Probably an obsessed person or just a nut job, but I have no idea who she is at all. Well, Phil, she's apparently somebody that imagined herself inside your ass with a giant horse dildo. That's who this girl is. So where else could we possibly go from here? How much more convoluted and fucking insane could this story get about a Twitch streamer getting fucked in the ass by an overpriced European hooker? Well, apparently quite a ways. Because it's a few days after the releasing of all this intimate details about their sex life that people begin to notice a few discrepancies, a few awkward things about Kimberly and her profiles. Those pictures that are being posted on Kimberly's Twitter account and on that website might not actually be Kimberly. They might have been stolen from a woman in fucking Memphis. So is this all some kind of bizarre troll that somebody set up 8 years ago to spring on DSP one day when they were bored? What exactly is happening? Why are all these pictures being attributed to somebody who looks like they might not even be a real person? Hopefully Kimberly can clear the, oh, wait a minute, I don't think she's going to clear up anything. What, you're going to delete all your tweets? What? Oh my god, it's okay, guys. It's okay. I was hacked. Somebody took my account. I'm not actually an escort whore. I've been hacked. Apparently somebody got into this account 8 years ago, and I finally noticed it. So I'm going to delete all these tweets, and I'm going to change the profile picture. I'm going to lock this baby down. Because I finally noticed, you know, 8 years later that I've been hacked. Sorry about that. Not actually a hooker from Europe. Oh, and the website's down too. That's really strange. So the Twitter account was hacked and now the rightful owner's taken it over. That's, I'm so glad for. And it looks like the website's been taken down, but how did that happen? I had that disgusting escort website taken offline because I don't want to be associated with disgusting things like that. Well, Kimberly Brink must be a fucking savant when it comes to technology to be able to pull down a website in like fucking 3 hours notice. I'm really impressed because technically Kimberly didn't own that website, so I have no idea how she took it down. But at least we're getting a consistent story from Kimberly now. It looks like some evil hacker took over that account 8 years ago to lay a booby trap for DSP. But luckily, Kimberly noticed just in the nick of time to take over the account and then pull down the website. Maybe Kimberly would be so gracious as to give me the tinfoil she had under that horse dildo so I can make a hat out of it and try to puzzle my way through this mystery. Maybe it was old man Jenkins down by the mill. I don't know, Scooby. Let's see if we can put this together. An account that's established for many years shows up and says DSP owes the money because she's a high-class escort. She provides all this information and pursues it for over a month. Then people notice that a few of the pictures belong to somebody else. All of a sudden that somebody else says, hey, wait a minute, that's actually my account that's been hacked 6 years ago. I'm going to take it over, and while I'm at it, I'm going to take down the escorting website because that's disgusting. Yet when asked about another account that she was talking to many years ago, she says, yes, I do know that account, we went to school together. Even though that account is saying that she's a hooker and that she was with DSP. Something's not adding up, I just can't put my finger on it. I mean, fucking what next? Are you going to tell me that it's Fred Fox and that Sons of Kojima have returned? Oh, fuck, yes, you are. Actually, that's exactly what you're going to do. The Sons will rise again. I'll be back. It seems that even if that website got pulled down, somebody put it back up with a simple message. Fred Fox. So our escort that's not really an escort who was actually hacked is now Fred Fox because Sons of Kojima has come back to mess with DSP. Am I following that right? Fred Fox set up an account 8 years ago to get DSP now? Oh no, wait. That's all a ruse as well. We are officially driving in the Lamborghini of autism. We go from like zero to retarded in like under a second. Because no, if you thought that that was actually Fred Fox, you've fallen for a ruse, my friend. It's actually the elite super hackers known as the Falcon. Yes, the Falcon has shown up. This has all been their master plan from the beginning. They wanted to teach DSP a lesson by first pretending to be a prostitute, then pretending to be the woman who got hacked and wasn't a prostitute, then pretending to pretend that they were a woman who got hacked by a prostitute, but they were actually Fred Fox. And then once you thought they were Fred Fox from the Sons of Kojima, in fact, they were actually the Falcon. Well, ain't that some shit. But is it possible this could get more autistic? Could we kick it up a notch? Could we get to fifth dimensional autism on the internet? Is that a possibility? Should I cross my fingers? Oh, I got a good feeling about this. I got a good feeling somebody's doing a little bit of digging. Could we kick this up a notch? Yes, we can. Y'all motherfuckers need to watch some more Rick and Morty. If you thought that Falcon shit was real, you fell for a ruse within a ruse within a ruse within a ruse. Because the real truth is that this is a catfishing empire that I swear to God, has been running for a decade now. Been run for a decade by this lovely couple. Take a look at them. Can we get a round of applause for the entertainment they've given us? Look at them. They're beautiful people. They use randomly found images of attractive women and then sucker stupid men out of money by either bribing them or tricking them. But apparently it backfired this time because it brought so much attention down on them that people were able to dig into the domains that they registered and find out what was going on. And they found out a whole bunch of information. I left the spoiler.
Which is interesting too, right? Because they've been doing this for a decade, yeah? And they picked this one target. which happened to be Phil Brunell. And the whole empire crumbles. Imagine that. Imagine you guys being criminal manipulators. You've been running a successful business for a decade. And you come across this is one lolcow, and it crumbles everything. It's bad enough that DSP is a plague on his own fan base, his own viewers, on people in his life, on every platform that he's on and everything he touches. But now some people who try to profit from him end up suffering some of the backlash as well. Oh, that's amazing. It's amazing. If this was Amber Lynn, if this was Chantel, if this was Chris Chan, if it was any other lolcow, they'd have gotten away with it. They would have gotten away with it. Probably. But boy, oh boy, they picked Phil Brunell. And look at what happened. Damn.
Takes on for this one. But use your imagination. It's going to really help, I think. Just visualize this. At some stage or another, the Angel Capri persona was picked up by a Twitter account called Slut Farmers. The picture in question seems to show what is assumed to actually be Miss Brenda inserting a child's baseball bat into her vagina. Her legs are spread wide, and a children's plastic golf club, cucumber, and various adult toys can be located conveniently nearby. I think it hits the nail on the head, and hopefully it does it before she can put that hammer in there, because God knows she's sticking everything else in there. So let me lay down a nice little summary for you. We've got a couple dedicated to running a catfishing empire, who are pretending to be a hacking group known as the Falcon, who is pretending to be Fred Fox, who is pretending to be a hacking victim, who is pretending to be an escort, who is trying to swindle $3,000 out of DSP by telling people they fucked him in the ass with a horse dildo. I fucking love the internet. But there is one last little bit. I mean, when we read about the baseball bat thing and Angelina Capri, that name popped up earlier too. It said, this fake escort's identity was linked back to another fake woman, Angelina Capri. This identity was much older than Kimberly Brink's name, and she had made a fatal error. In registering a domain name and putting up an Amazon wish list to swindle patrons, they had revealed their true identities. So it seems like this persona was the key piece of information that ended up unraveling the entire mystery. A whole month-long adventure completely solved because of one fuck-up on the part of this scamming couple. God, if only somebody at the very beginning of this had clued in on that. if they had clued in on that particular persona and did some investigation and found that, hey, this might actually be a catfishing endeavor. If only somebody had made an image macro, explaining it and laying it out in simple terms for people to look at. Well, you know what? It doesn't matter. Somebody with a keen wit like that, high intelligence, handsome, good-looking, attractive, great in bed, that kind of person probably doesn't exist. And if they did, they'd probably just enjoy a good shit show. Don't we all?
Oh, man. Oh. I didn't see any of those tweets either until the video came out, so it is what it was. But it's amazing how that slipped by. But it is what it is. It is what it is. Ladies and gentlemen, we're not actually done with that. Well, we're done with it for now. We're going to have to review that later, because I would like for us to take a second look at the Escort Saga. Just because of... there's just a lot of discrepancies. Like, Metacritic wraps it all up in a nice, neat little bow. Don't get me wrong. But there are certain aspects of things that Phil has said. There's other weird little circumstances that popped out. There's a lot of weird shit around that whole thing. And then, like I said, like Metacritic had said about Kimberly saying that she got her money, and then 2 weeks later she goes back on Phil. And I hold the theory that Phil may have actually paid her some money to go away for a little while. But, as any of you know, if you're ever extorted, if you pay once, you'll pay again. That's why the United States, as well as a lot of countries, don't negotiate with terrorists. If you succumb to their demands once, you'll more than likely do it again. So, but that's neither here nor there. Very interesting stuff. Like I said, ladies and gentlemen, the link to the original video, if I can find it, will be down in the description. If not, there's someone else that's mirrored it. And I will also mirror, well, yeah, we're going to mirror the channel over here too. I guess I'll be doing it, I should say. I'll mirror the video on this channel as well, so you guys have that for posterity's sake. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for listening in. I very much appreciate it. Season's greetings and happy holidays. Merry Christmas. Hope you guys get everything you guys want. Hope everything works out well for you. And if we don't see you in the days after this, then we'll probably see you sometime in 2020. Hopefully. Take care of yourselves out there. Enjoy your friends and family. You know what I mean? Enjoy the holiday season. You know what I mean? The world is a very interesting place. And you should, if you can, if you have the opportunity, take advantage of this time that you have with the people that you care about. You know what I mean? All right, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for being here for the 12 days of Christmas / Snoutmas. I very much appreciate it. We're going to go with a different name next year. if there is a next year for us. But thank you guys very much for being here with us. I very much appreciate it. We all do. For everybody here at GTG Network and Productions, DSP News, The Snort Report, Snortbucks Coffee, and and Hard Snorts, Gin and Tonic. Take care of yourselves, guys. Mm-hmm.